Hello. Welcome back to We Were Rooting For You. I am your host, Mark Bupard of Gambit Magazine, contributing editor, and joined by my trusty sidekick, Samir Roy.
Hello, co-host Samir Roy here, also a contributing editor at Gambit Magazine, especially when it comes to anything top model related.
So we all know why you're here. It's because, I mean, unless you want to ruin for you, you just watched The Girl Who Got Dolled Up.
Oh my God. And again, my God, 2 weeks in a row, I am like so proud of Ty Ty Baby because she was able to actually connect the title of her episode with something that was, you know, actually happened and was a large part of the episode as opposed to a 5 second moment with a forgettable person that's going to be eliminated in a couple more episodes anyways. Like this time I was like, oh, this actually describes what I'm going to see like for the majority of the show. Okay, and now I'm seeing it. I get it.
I don't know why, but I keep trying to associate it with, like, which gender is going to go home or which gender is going to do better since I guess maybe she started this, like, versus theme that I secretly keep holding on to for one reason or another. So the girl who got dolled up, I was kind of disappointed that it doesn't really apply to the ending of this episode. I mean, everybody got dolled up, and especially the chicks. I don't really...
I guess it's true. Like, you know, there wasn't just one girl dolled up.
Is it about Lacey?
Is it?
Because she's just going from, like, stride to stride? I mean, I don't know.
Or maybe, you know, maybe it was specifically referring to Hadassah because she unveiled. We heard it in the preview of this episode from last week, but that she had she collects dolls and she has over 300.
Ugh.
And so this was, like, a challenge clearly made for her. And then we saw this, like, perfect doll face in the challenge that then we didn't see represented in the photo they chose.
Well, we gotta give props where props are due. Her face was again in focus. This is an astonishing, like, fourth time in a row.
I know. This is quite a run you have going here, Tyra's boyfriend, Eric something or other.
Yeah, wait, Tyra. Eric Banks? Is that your name? His first name's Bangs, Eric, right?
Banks.
Yeah. Mr. Tyra. Like, we should just call him Mr. Tyra.
Mr. Tyra.
I mean, how like else that. Is he getting every single photo shoot job after the incident with Hadassah in, like, episode 2?
Combine one show that has trouble attracting respected photographers and one photographer who is desperately seeking respect who can't find anywhere. And you have a cheap photographer for the show.
We have Mr. Tyra Banks, everybody.
Mr. Tyra.
Well... well, Mr. Takara kept Hadassah's face in focus, thank God. But yeah, poor photo choice. We've never been privy to it, but it would always be nice if we could kind of see some of their role.
That
film.
Could be like a good addition for like the next season, maybe. Like, hey, let's see them actually going through this process of looking at all the photos. Because sometimes they do that when they let the models do it themselves in certain challenges.
Like the retouching challenge.
Yeah, and so it's like, oh, okay, well, at least you get to see, like,
others, a little bit.
A little bit of, like, what the other options were in terms of a photograph, even though in that particular case it was before they were retouched.
Mm-hmm.
But nonetheless, it's nice to see, like, what else they produce, because you get to see, like, a few seconds of their shoot, and usually we're tricked. They try to trick us because we'll see like, oh, that looks amazing. That looks really good. Then you get to the finished photo, like, this was your best shot. And I'm like, were all those other shots where her face looked amazing all out of focus again, so you had no choice but not to choose them? I mean, that didn't stop you earlier this season, so I don't understand. And even then, they didn't even pick her best expression. It was still a bad expression, and it was out of focus, which didn't even help it, surprisingly. But this time, it was just
combined
like,
with, like, actual movement. She was falling in that photo. It was all too much for the camera to take.
Well, there was no movement.
Mr. Tyra to remember to keep in focus.
Yeah, no movement this week to trouble the photographer.
Yeah, since they were all supposed to be dolls.
Mr. Tyra had an easier time keeping it in focus because there was nothing to put the image out of focus once the camera was sitting there.
I just love that nickname, Mr. Tyra.
That's what he's going to be called all season, I guess.
Or forever until they stop dating or something.
I mean, he does have a name. His name is Eric, I think.
It is. But with like a K?
Yeah, with a K. But I can never remember his last name.
Which
is probably
I always
a problem
say
that a lot of people who direct photo shoots for any kind of fashion house probably have a problem with, you know, and it comes to him like, oh, what's his, I don't remember.
He's not. He's not, but I always want to say Oslo, but that's not
Osla.
It. There you go.
Osla.
See? There you go. I have to do like a little word association with it.
It's just how we came to remember who that designer from Project Runway was. Kendall, Kylie, Kenley. That's how it came together.
Came together with yes, a K.
With a K. With
so you know K. It's part of the Kardashians. Anyway,
that was. But nonetheless, we jumped ahead just because we had to kind of throw that out there, because that really was what the title referred to. So we had to give you a little taste of that. But there was a glorious mini challenge where all went to a school and, like, models going back to school. Something tells me a lot of these people should have stayed in rooms like this earlier in their life, and they probably would not have ended up on America's Next Top Model. But, I don't know, every now and then you get surprised. There was that Elise in this first season who was going to go to be a doctor.
And then made a slight detour onto America's Next South Top Model. Into South
Asia after. Yeah, she went to, I don't know how she
What happened to your flight path?
I don't know. Went to Hong Kong to make a whole bunch of money and then come back. But nonetheless, she was somebody who clearly was educated and been to school, but you don't get the sense that a lot of these people have really been to school that much. So
I mean, Lacey, for instance, can't be more than like a year or two out of high school anyway.
Like just finished high school. She had to have.
Yeah. So I don't expect that, especially like considering how young they are, even though this episode did have some glorious foreshadowing that may or may not have came true, that Devin's birthday was happening while this episode was being shot. He was turning 22. He is convincing no one, least of which me, that you are turning only 22. Please give me a break.
22, 5 years ago, maybe.
Maybe. That's in Germany when you signed your
first agency.
But other than Devin, I feel like most people have been like in and out of college or maybe like had just even recently finished college. Like I think Niall's like 24 or something. So maybe a recent college grad, but you know, that in a weird transitional phase seems to be like the collective age of everybody. Maybe not all of them have spent that much time post high school education.
Let's see, who do we get talk from? Well, right away, Bejo.
Well, he had a wonderful introduction, which was, we see kind of the beginning of the end of his friendship with Hadassah, which was always kind of weird. I never really got that. And then he
says that faded line, like, I'm not here to make friends. I'm like, oh, no one who has ever said that line has won. Well, I'm sure somebody somewhere has, but on the majority, when you say that in a show, it's like, you are definitely not going to win. I didn't come here.
And it was just very interesting that Hadassah got a lot nicer when she stopped hanging out with him. She started talking about how she started it all. Well, because
Mikey came through the kitchen and he was like, "Oh, you know, I'm so sorry the way I talked and treated you guys." And
well, because he senses that the end is nigh now that they've lost the A of MDA,
DMA,
whatever.
DMA. I think that's what it was.
Yeah, it is DMA because it's just DM, which makes you think about BM. So, yeah, and that's exactly what they are.
So apparently Mikey realizing that his Survivor alliance didn't pan out. I mean, you picked Devin as part of your alliance. Did you think that was going to work?
Why?
But nonetheless, he's come to realize at some point that perhaps this is not even though he spends the rest of the episode hanging out with him anyways, that maybe it's not the best way to be. Don't be like Devin.
He's just enjoying Devin's short amount of time that he has left on this earth in Top Model.
On the Top Model planet.
Yeah. He's going to be jettisoned into space. Actually. We all know what's going to happen at the end.
Instead of from the beginning, that's what it looks like, and that's probably exactly what happens.
Well, last season, I think, embodied it the best when they were, like, in Seoul, and it was kind of futuristic.
That's true. It did kind of, like, come to an apotheosis there.
Yeah, it looked the most like 2001 in there.
Yeah. Yes, but that's the feeling you always get in that Top Model judging room. I mean, it does sort of feel like almost like an alien, like, goddess throne, like where Tyra sits now. As, you know, she kind of fills that role in our lives.
Yeah, I feel like the judging panel this season looks a little too, like, really nice IKEA for some reason. A
really nice IKEA?
Yeah, like the one that they have, like, headquarters in Sweden or whatever. That's what it looks like.
I was still amazed that you're supposed to get lost in. So you wind up.
That's exactly why I think that. Because of, like, the way that.
In a cafe somewhere in the middle of it.
The maze of, like, just a, you know, it's like a catwalk, but it just, like, sends you back up. And it's also, like, a plank to send you off the show.
It's probably what the set is like, you know, when they actually go to film, like, behind that spaceship room that they all go into.
Spaceship room. Because they're just hovering around LA to cut production costs.
That's right. Yeah, but you know, those gravity boots have to be really expensive to be made. So into it's the form
really
of
they just
heels.
Break even is what really ends up happening.
You know, she may have graduated from that business school, but it doesn't mean that it's like totally paying dividends in every way.
Once again, it was 6 weeks. I don't know if that's really school as much as it's a course or an online class, if you will.
Yeah, I know. Was she there physically?
I don't know.
I'm like, you think we would have had a lot of Instagram moments of Tyra on the, like, campus of Harvard?
She has thousands of pictures. I'm not going back that far. I don't have 2 hours.
The Harvard Business School. There's got to be pictures out there.
I feel like I've seen, like, a couple of, like, the Instagram. But it's her. It's after the fact where she's, like, holding up
it's
the diploma
framed.
It's probably
just, like, a
or the
a
certification,
school,
whichever.
Where, like, Harvard is spelled with an E instead of a second A. And then she just deliberately misspells it when she talks about it on TV.
No, I think it's at Harvard. I don't know.
You never know.
We
you
should
never
go
know.
Back to that. But
nothing is real.
We should also get back to Bea and Hadassah's drama and the dissolution of the friendship. Oh, and how Courtney is sadly trying to join the end of DMA.
She's
and
trying
make
to
it...
make it DMC. And I'm like, why? Why? I mean, it was really sad. Like, she comes prancing around and, like, skipping around them and trying to be like
in the
Laura
in a dress
B.
that Hadassah lent her. And she later lets Devin do her makeup, which is the strangest way to get somebody to, like, try and like you and be your friend. Why? He, no.
Why would you want him to do your makeup? Does he look like he knows how to do makeup?
I don't know why. That would not
Maybe
be my
he
first.
Does. Maybe that's a skill that he has that we just haven't heard about yet. It just doesn't seem likely.
But we've heard about 6 agencies that he signed to.
He says that a lot.
Yeah. You think he wouldn't drop like, a girl, I can do some mean eyeliner work? He should.
Like, when and where did you work with these agencies as a makeup artist and not a model?
That would solve a lot of questions.
Maybe that's how. Yeah. You know, but, like, I'm wondering if he also just confuses, like, getting a business card from a modeling agency as, like, being signed by the agency. Like, I have 6 business cards in my portfolio. No photos and no jobs. But I was quote-unquote signed. Just like I'm quote-unquote 22.
That man is not 22 years old.
No. I mean, he acts like he's, well, 2. But... to be completely honest. Like,
but it's not closer to 22. I mean, I understand that he lost his virginity in this business.
And
but
what age was that? He never really specified. Or where. Or, you know, was
I don't want
to,
any of those details,
maybe he was trying
I don't
to
think.
Protect the identity of the person who, like, had way too much absinthe that night somewhere
Why
in a Berlin modeling
absinthe?
Agency. I don't know. It had to be something strong. Jägermeister. Gasoline, I don't know.
Gasoline sounds probably right up his alley.
Or grappa.
Some mezcal. They hit up a nice mezcal bar.
Sounds like something some douchey hipster model would do, though.
Mezcal Mondays.
Mezcal Mondays. Fuck margaritas.
Guaranteed to make you hate yourself on Tuesday. Or even, like, by 9 p.m., depending on what time you start.
Or hate your decision-making process.
But there were foreboding signs all over this losery bunch. And it was only irony coming to full fruition when they get to the school, when the models get sent to the school for their mini challenge to make a STEM PSA. They get broken out into 3 teams, and we'll get into the STEM PSA, Tyra's little message to the models, mm-hmm. and then the themes. But yeah. Courtney, Devin and Bayo all end up on a team together, and it's just the saddest, like, uninspired group of people. And Bayo's already pissed. So that's just, like, another little check in the loser edit box that goes next to his name. And I have to say, in between, you called it the Elizabethan bun.
Yeah.
And his little turban, He was just missing a crystal ball.
Yes, right?
I don't know how he didn't
like,
see this coming.
It was almost like, remember, that was it last season when Tyra Dawn did that whole, like, fortune teller thing with
Oh, but that was after she, like, made everybody spit into a test tube to test their heritage. And so she went into like a gypsy's room to have her DNA read to her. It was very strange.
It's like he was channeling also, like,
they instantly cut to like a very different camera that was handheld, and they like cut to her like walking backstage like it was some sort of secret, like what it looks like back there.
Like an expose documentary or something.
Or just like athletes coming out into the field or some shit. Like you almost expected fans, or maybe Tyra really wanted to squeeze some fans in that narrow ass fire hazard hallway that she was squeezing down to get into like the gypsy's room.
The gypsy room.
Only to be encouraged to use a really shitty British accent, which totally ties back to tonight's episode because she has an excuse to use a shitty British accent during the main challenge.
That's true.
We'll when get she describes Bayo's doll, but we can get to that.
Oh my god, yeah, it was awful. But yeah, so the whole point of this challenge was she brings him into this classroom full of young girl students.
Yes.
And there's a bunch of like scientific equipment lying around.
It looks like they're in science class or biology.
None of them are using the equipment or doing
anything.
But
they never also specified like what the age, I'm not sure what the age.
It was various ages I could tell from the girls when you saw them all like judging. Because they also get, these girl students are not just an audience. They're actually the judges of the final product of the challenge, which is to create a Vine / public service announcement about the gender inequality in the science, tech, engineering, and math fields of employment and education. So that's why there's all girls there not using any of those things.
But and if you want to know what the fuck a Vine PSA is, it's a 6-second PSA.
Well, a Vine is 6 seconds. So I'm like, why did you have to make the PSA a Vine? Like, if the goal is to, like, bring attention
why
to something.
Did they use the Oppo phone?
That's yes, they did. They used them. They used them as their cameras to film their Vines.
Great. But why couldn't we just use Oppo phone editing technology to make a regular length PSA? Especially the amount of time given to make a 6-second Vine. I don't know.
They give them an hour.
Why do you need that much time?
You need, like, 10 minutes. I mean, granted, they had to come up with their idea. They had to come up with their story.
Okay.
But, I mean, how long? It has to only last 6 seconds.
You should also never overthink those.
Exactly. And this is the perfect group of people to not overthink something, is a group of people competing to be America's Next Top Model. So you should have been pretty much guaranteed that no one was going to overthink it, you know. But at least there were some intelligent people who didn't overthink it and did a good video, but they didn't win. Nonetheless, it was like, okay, an hour. How many Vines could we create in an hour? I mean, each one takes 6 seconds. I mean, they were editing together, like, 2 shots or something.
3.
2 or 3, but it's like,
I feel like most of them had 3 shots. I feel like it was pretty consistent. I do feel like Niall, Lacey, and Justin's team had more than 3 shots. And maybe, they came up with a pretty complete concept. I would argue also maybe, like, too full of a concept to fit within 6 seconds. I'm not sure.
Well, whole subject is too big to fit into 6 seconds. I'm like, you're going to use this opportunity on your show to talk about the inequality of pay and the inequality of numbers of women to men in this industry.
Math and engineering and science.
Yeah, science, tech, math, and science, tech, engineering, and math, STEM. But how exactly are they supposed to tell that story if each of them only gets 6 seconds to do it? And then they have some comedian Vine star, who's there to help them, sort of.
Well, we should talk about what the themes are for each team.
Oh, yeah,
because they get broken out into 3
STEM
teams.
STEM brings you power, money, and respect. In a lot of student loan bills.
I feel like that's on top of it being only 6 seconds, I feel like that's a very muddled message to try and get across.
Like, oh, this is how being in the science, tech, engineering, and math fields brings me money. Yes, because so many mathematicians are just rolling in dough.
Right. And I don't really know. That's just like a mixed message. Like, study because you'll get paid. I don't know. It's, you don't think that these young women aren't doing it because they already like to and that they're good at it? Like, do we have to kind of...
We don't even know if they were students in any of those fields that were, or that students that were particularly had pronounced abilities in those fields. They We didn't learn anything about those girls. We just learned that they were sitting in the room waiting for the models to walk in and that they get to watch the videos on their phones afterwards. And of course, we learned that letting children make some sort of actual judgment on something, even something as puerile and childish as a top model mini challenge, was not the best decision because the video they picked, what was it, Team Respect, was Mikey and Adasa and Mame. And their video was really just Mikey hitting on them, you know, like in a high school. Where did they find the high school?
They were in a high school.
They were in a high school. I thought it was an elementary school, but I don't know. My elementary Maybe school it's didn't a middle have school. Any lockers. I don't know. So I was like, it had to be a high school, but these kids look too young to be them unless they're all prodigies who've been advanced to high school level science
classes. Well, sometimes you'll, like after school programs can be in like in the high school or a different school. That's true. But it also could have been, it doesn't matter. Semantics.
But like, okay, so he's hitting on the two girls. And then they're like, no. And then he's like, tutor me. And I'm like, I don't understand how you got from there to there to there in this 6 seconds. Because I'm like, how does this tell the... Why is he asking you two to tutor him exactly?
Well, because I think it's like he comes up to them. They look like they're maybe going to go... I don't know. I mean, I'm inferring here. But it looks like maybe they're going to go study. And so they're grossed out by him trying to hit on them. And then... I think, he tells them you're too hot to study or some shit like that. And then they're like, ew, and start walking away. He's like, where are you going? And they say, respect, I think. Maybe he doesn't say, where are you going? Because that wouldn't make sense as a response. But I don't know. I didn't write quotes, the script. And then he gets down on his knees and screams, tutor me, in like an attempt. Because Mikey, I mean, did this with his own bed. So he's not one that's easily turned down or deterred when there is poon involved. So he gets down on his knees and screams, tutor me, even though it would be a gigantic waste of their time because he is untutorable.
One would imagine.
I imagine.
It didn't really...
Correctly.
Did you learn anything about how being good at science, tech, engineering, or math somehow benefits you as a woman? Like, did you get that message out of that video?
I mean, I didn't, to be fair, I mean, actually, no. No, I did not. I think, yeah, Lacey, Niall, and Justin, mainly Lacey and Niall.
Yes, Justin, I still don't remember what he was doing.
He was the other dude there, he was right?
I mean, none of them were speaking in theirs. They didn't have any lines in theirs. They actually just
told
it
with
Justin.
Well, it was nice that Niall was really relieved that he got paired with Lacey and Justin because he said that in his confessional says that they're the only ones that make it a real effort to try and communicate with him one-on-one. And so it was nice that they put their heads together and decided that they should do a completely silent Vine, which, I mean, all of this sounds like really silly. Like, I want to say silent PSA. I'm not sure how to say this, but
it, like, you
a 6-second video with no talking.
I mean, they had to boil it down into something that you could tell in 6 seconds.
They got the terrible theme of money, which is like, and they gave it some sort of meaning. And it was really, I thought they did a good job, and they fit a lot into their hour. I mean, they definitely made more than 6 seconds worth.
They got one.
And I feel bad that they really don't get to shoot for longer.
They could have made something possibly even better. But, you know, they I thought they did it the most intelligently, I guess, considering the medium they were working in here. It's like, okay, one shot of dudes being douchey dudes. Mm-hmm. Oh, they had the sign, the boys rule, girls drool. It's kind of like, what's that line from, what was it called? An American Journey? Homeward Bound. Remember that movie, Homeward Bound, with the dog, two dogs and the cat on their like cross-country journey to find like the family that I guess decided when they had to move, they didn't want to take their pets.
Yeah,
with
that's
them,
what I never understood about that movie. It was like, you guys got abandoned.
I'm like, aren't you moving into a house? Like, why can't you?
They were just terrible white people.
As is the case with most. No offense, dear Margot.
I don't count.
You're okay. You're good with me. But nonetheless, it was like, it kind of had that kind of, I don't know, I was getting that vibe.
Homeward Bound. I got that vibe from Courtney all night, just to be
fair. Oh my god, that poor abandoned thing.
They just kept trying to abandon her in a parking lot, and she just kept galloping back, but that's neither here nor there. Lacey, Niall, and Justin's video was the best, but ultimately did not win. But it was a very cute concept that kind of made the most of their 6 seconds by starting with, like,
Lacey, sign, the dudes with the money, and then Lacey's like, oh no, and she tears up the sign that they drew up that says boys rules.
Well, she gets like a light bulb above her head.
It says STEM in it.
Yeah. So they were the only ones that actually kind of like incorporated STEM.
And then she tears up that sign and she's like, hell no, because I've got the power of my aptitude in science, tech, engineering, and math.
Yeah, they just had a shot of her with like a bunch of books all over the place, and then she opens a briefcase with money.
But that's how you have to tell a story in 6 seconds. You have to tell it basically with the images, not with the words.
Like they did themselves a I feel like they did themselves a huge favor by actually not bothering with writing dialogue that doesn't matter, so that nobody has to worry about remembering anything else than just like the basic concept.
Mm-hmm.
Because I feel like, and even one of the kids kind of points out in like the feedback that Lacey has like a really good model strut ahead of like the boys at the very end, where she like has money, but she's like throwing money. She's making it rain.
She's making it rain on them this time.
Yeah, but she's also runway. Yeah, exactly. And that I felt like really worked for them, but Team Power
was just an unmitigated disaster all the way through.
I mean, it was first terrible that they didn't know how to work the Vine app, which I feel is, I've never used it, but I feel like it's very self-explanatory.
It seems like it was a poor decision. It's like, okay, who's going to do the filming? Okay, who does not know how to use this phone very well? You're going to film. Like, okay, how did they come to that decision? Did they even ask each other? Like, okay, who's uses, of the three, I would imagine Devin uses the phone the most.
Which gets proven later phone, on.
Oh, poop phone, whatever.
Oppo, right? Oppo.
It is kind of like poop, but inverted.
You're so right.
You oh just my take God. The, you just
the poop phone.
It's oh the my poop God. Phone
we have two new amazing nicknames in one episode. We're not even 30 minutes in.
I love us. Yeah, me too.
Mr. Tyra would approve.
We would have made, we would have made a hell of a lot better Vine.
I feel like we should try and make as many vines as possible in an hour just to prove how easy it is.
Oh my gosh. This whole podcast should have just been vines. It'll be a vine cast.
I think that's a real thing.
Is it really?
I think so.
I like that. With that character on that Scream Queen show, the girl who says...
Oh, don't spoil it yet. I haven't watched it.
Oh my God. You haven't watched it yet. It's interesting. I can't spoil anything for you. I think it's going to work itself out. It's going to settle in.
Okay.
It kind of did it towards... It was a 2-hour...
I know.
You can cut this all out. Sorry, this is just a breather. But but nonetheless, I did watch all 2 hours of it. It was... it has promise, I will say. Jamie Lee Curtis is really funny.
Oh, yay.
Well, I think she's really funny, but they're all, like, horrible people.
That's fine.
Characters. I'm fine with the two. And Nick Jonas is in it as a gay fraternity bro.
Huh.
Very adorable. Already, his character seems to have some interesting things happening, so let's see where that goes. Fun stuff. But nonetheless, I guess since I'm not ruining that, nonetheless, but Vinecast. Vinecasts are apparently a real thing.
I really think so. I really do.
I'm very disturbed by this.
I know.
We should just do one anyway sometimes.
No, we should totally take that challenge. And when we do, we'll tweet it out and you guys can see it if you want to watch what that would look like.
Maybe we can use the new iPhone.
We'll use your new iPhone. Then we can shoot a movie.
Because it does. Oh my God, we totally could.
Does 4K, right?
I have. Oh yeah, just 4K.
Oh, jeez.
I have 28 gigs, y'all.
That you're going to fill up so quick.
With the new photos, like it's almost like, okay, like to bring it back to top model, the new photo thing on the new iPhone is very like Flixels. Almost, with, like, the movement before and after your photograph.
Oh, yeah, I heard it's, like, a halfway GIF.
Kind of, because it's, like, when you take a picture, it'll record, like, the moment before and the moment after the photo. So in case there was, like, you know, like, oh, my God, I just mistimed this photo. Like, the great moment happened, like, just a split second after I took the photo. Well, it'll have the video of that. But in the commercial, it looked really cool. I'm wondering how cool it's going to look when it's just selfies.
Well,
it's just
going to
be, like... Oh my God, you look so. Oh, did I drink? Like, that's what all of them are going to be like for people who just take selfies. So, in the top model house of the Oppo phone had that feature. That's pretty much what you get most of the time.
That would be like, Devin's role.
I hate you, Glug. You're amazing.
Oh, man.
Nobody talks to me. You know, because
no,
that's what was happening. It was a whole, it was like, you know, obviously I was kind of impressed that the show didn't just like breeze past the whole Niall, like having trouble communicating with people thing after the last episode. They're
but
like,
it's been,
we addressed it. It's done. We're moving on. It's
yeah,
like,
they
well,
keep still, I'm impressed. Well, he's also doing so well. I'm sure he lasts a long time and that this is going to be a running theme for him. So
that people, even after last week, just sort of went
back
to old ways
of
not.
The sign and dine dinner with all with everybody that every that
they got
people,
the message then, but
I think a few people kind of retain that. Like Niall even says, again repeating myself, that Lacey and Justin are the ones that make a true effort. He already, I think he really kind of saw a lot of Devin's character, if
mm-hmm.
you will, during the sign and dine, because he was the one that made the least amount of effort. So
the
way that
thing,
Devin behaves later on is really not surprising.
I mean, and the birthday party was planned by Courtney, who was trying to apologize for doing poorly in their challenge. I'm like, well, really, it was your partners who sucked because you looked good in it. Actually, her performance was the believable
well,
part
she
of the
was
whole
the one,
thing.
Oh, poor thing.
Where she was the one who was abused by the people, and then she's like, who's got the power? Even that, when she, the way she delivered that line was convincing, but the whole concept added together with the imbecilic additions of Devin and Bayo just dragged it down so much, but she was the one who left feeling like she had ruined it for them and felt like she had to put this little party together for Devin to make him feel better. And of course, what does Devin do? He gets drunk and then takes Niall's phone to take selfies. No, everyone knows that, like, that's his only method of communication with them. It's because that's how he understands what they're saying, because nobody even has the decency to look him in the face or make sure that he can see them when they're speaking to him. They're just acting like he's somebody who can hear exactly the same way as them. And they just are too self-centered to get past that. A lot of them are. And he's the worst at it, going to the point of literally taking his tool that enables him to even marginally be a part of what's happening around him. It, like, I was just like, you took that away so you could take like a million pictures of yourself in a competition where they're always taking pictures of you. There is a fucking camera on you right now. Can't you just take...
Don't they they have a selfie booth room thing. That's what that's for, remember?
Like, there's so... That, they forgot
they
all
haven't
about
used
that.
That room in forever. They keep using the poop phone to
the
take their stupid
phone.
Selfies instead of letting poor... That's for Niall to use.
I was just like, oh my God, even Courtney was like, she's like, well... We
it even...
Take
it finally
away.
Sunk in for her. I mean, she's very apathetic. Because we unfortunately...
Apathetic?
Or I'm sorry, empathetic. Whoa, I'm tired.
I'm like, I don't think she's apathetic. She seems a little kind of sweet, actually.
No, no, we find out how empathetic she is because she gets the kind of kiss of death, if you will, by any sort of reality show.
When she
needs.
Says, oh yeah, when she gets criticized in her in the main challenge, like, haven't you read this Vogue magazine? Read Italian
well,
Vogue? And
before
like,
that, she talks about how she takes care of her younger disabled brother, that she's
and,
a
yeah.
second full-time mom to him. And as soon as she said that, I was just like, ah, shit.
Oh, bye, girl.
But she was the first. She was the first one to notice that Niall was starting to feel excluded and left out, and brought it attention. That's that was the open door that Top Model walked through, and she just. She sealed her coffin up pretty tight right there. I mean, the rest of the episode was just hard to watch because as soon as she
we
dropped,
knew what was gonna happen.
As soon as she dropped the disabled brother bomb, I was like, "And you're out." But it was, I mean, it was a double elimination this week, so
I know, but I, for no real reason, really.
Well, I think the reason that we come to find out is that next week is gonna be they do have the comeback episode.
She
just
we hasn't
just
been
don't,
talking about it. She hasn't mentioned it once.
Not at all. I guess maybe she just assumes that we all remember, but because she got rid of social media scores, it was just kind of hard to determine.
Now it's all a secret.
Now it's all a secret, and now it really
guess.
Goes back to just being, it comes down to like quote unquote challenge scores. Like they get to, it seems like she did exactly what RuPaul did on Drag Race, which is bring all of the queens, or I'm sorry, bring all of the models back, not
yes.
the queens, and have them all duke it out to see who
earn
stays and goes.
That spot.
Yeah.
With ghosties? Or is that
with
after
ghosties
they
and
it
looked like they had a photo challenge.
All of them, though? I didn't
yes.
see any. Did you see the other people in the preview? I only saw
I
Bejo
saw,
come back.
I saw Bejo come back, but I also saw Ava in that horrible mullet.
Oh,
how could
thing.
You? I mean, she was right behind Bayo, but like, I saw her hair before I saw her face, and I was like, oh, I'm
so,
sorry.
So it means that they all had to keep their looks until this moment.
Yeah. But I mean, the
they've
second.
They've probably been in a hotel somewhere in like.
That's what I assumed.
North Hollywood.
Because they also, they just shove him back into the house. It also seems to be
the case. You don't get to live in a nice house. We're going to send you to the ghetto.
No, but as soon as they get back on the show for this one episode, they get shuffled back into the house. And then they get sent back into the wild for good.
Slumber party. No.
Sleep with one eye open, everyone.
For reals. But yeah, so we after the birthday party drama and people being rude to, well, anybody who wasn't them, I guess, for the majority of that party. Everybody was just drunk and foolish, and it was just
Devin but being a jerk. At least like Mame apologized, and everybody started to notice. And like, I feel like Devin was the only one who was like, "Whatever, Mame, keep taking selfies. That won't help you, bitch. It's not gonna help." Mm-mm. Ugh, good God. But I mean, just to briefly go back to their video and how they kind of they got clumped together for this mini challenge, Devin, Bayo, and Courtney. And then they just kind of, they just had like a stench about him for like the rest of the episode where you just knew that was like going to be the bottom three no matter what.
The bottom three skunks sprayed all over them and it stunk up the whole house for the rest of the show.
I think, well, Bayo goes on to accidentally delete the Vine video after they've like supposedly completed it and they only have
right after they filmed the last shot.
Yeah, surprise, surprise, the guy who has no idea how to work this phone deletes the whole thing.
Oh, wait, I think I just deleted that.
And so they have to rush through it all again, and it gives off the impression that you're being yelled at for 6 seconds.
Well, if they had Wi-Fi, it could have been saved in the cloud, but no, they have to be sequestered.
How does it not get automatically backed up? I mean, even still, how do you not just, like, save that? Like, it deletes the whole file?
I mean, there's got to be some, I don't know how this shit works.
I guess it really should
have known.
I know,
but. Or maybe an Oppo poop phone representative who should be on set at all times to handle any poop phone related issues. Maybe, you know, a little fiber laxative to clear out the poop phone.
Oh, you went there.
I did. but nonetheless, there should have been some other...
But this is exactly why we should do a Vine cast, so that we could truly understand the difficulties of working a two-button app.
Yes, exactly.
That would cause you to delete it.
Record,
needless to say,
stop.
They didn't win.
No, they did not win. They were clearly the worst of the three.
And, I mean, it just translated...
And it carried over through everything the rest of the
right
episode.
Into the main challenge.
Because in the main challenge, they all sucked. Like, Devin was supposed to be head to teed up.
Oh, well,
so it's like a golfing doll.
Let's just go back. Oh, how did we almost forget? So Tyra talks. We have to go all the way back to the mini challenge really quick. So when Tyra delivers her little, like, this is what your mini challenge is going to be. You're going to make a Vine PSA. What jumpsuit is she wearing?
Oh my God, she's wearing the jumpsuit from the elimination of the previous episode, which means she went right from, like, doing that elimination to filming this bit.
Mini challenge.
Like this video, and I was like, oh my God, the highlighter platypus bill was
the elephant
still
gray
there.
Power suit? One-armed power suit?
One-armed power jumpsuit.
I've been thinking about it a little bit. It kind of looks like something that would be in Tron.
Kind of.
I mean, like, and it almost seems like her collars could be, like, those Nike pumps. Like, it would just, like, inflate.
Oh, I would love that. There's, like, those little bubbles that you use
and
to
pump
air
would, like,
into
affect,
your collar.
Yeah, and maybe it would, like, also affect, like, the shoulder pads. Like, give her bigger shoulders or, like, smaller shoulders. I don't know.
She's like, I'm feeling Joan Crawford today. Pump, 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 pump.
Yeah, maybe. I think we're also making this pant jumpsuit thing way cooler than it is.
That's true, because it really was not cool.
It's definitely worth noting that this monstrosity makes an appearance.
Again, a second appearance. It was. You'd think that she would have already checked, like, the social media.
I feel like this highlighter yellow, though, is, like, her power color this season, because it's
popped up repeatedly.
Yeah, it's been a reoccurring theme. It's in the opening credit, the CEO Gangster's Paradise cold open, where she is Michelle Pfeiffer, clearly.
If she, yeah.
I don't know. Or, like, slash, like, she's giving me some Janet Jackson at the end, where she, like, she's definitely 90s.
There's no Dylan contest happening here, though.
But, so it's in there. It's in the nightmarish Tyra suite.
Mm-hmm.
That highlighter yellow everywhere that we call
That's
out
true.
Every single week because it just, like, it kills our eyes to have to look
like,
at it.
Like, I feel like when you turn the lights off, those walls still glow.
Right? I mean, I already assume that. That's not how that room works.
I'm not sure. We haven't seen anybody try to go to sleep in it. It's like, it's possibly, it's like those, like, they've all been treated the way, like, you know, when there's a crime scene and you treat the walls, when you turn the lights, you see all the blood. I bet when you turn the lights off in that room, it's like the blood of all these, like, lost contestants.
Oh, my God.
It's splattered all over that room, and those highlighter yellow walls are just making it glow, so nobody actually can sleep in that room.
It's probably just to, like, keep that week's winner on their toes to, like, try and bring...
This could be you.
It. Yeah.
On the walls. You watch your step. You take my tie tips, and you work from them.
Well, so the highlighter yellow also... It gives you nightmares, and it's also hiding blood. And it was, I'm bringing it to this week, in the main challenge, it was... The color of the box that Ty was in, and also the color of Lacey's box. So maybe it's their power color.
Maybe. Because Lacey's...
Maybe she's trying to... Maybe Tyra watched a little bit too much Mad Men and really is feeling Peggy's mustard yellow as her power color.
It looked much better on Lacey.
It did. I mean, that dress looked amazing.
And the wig that they gave her.
Yeah.
And, like, it was perfection. She was perfection in that photo. She, like, just instantly, like, snapped into the role. And I love that, like, when Tyra was criticizing people, I think it was Bayo, of course, later, and she was like, oh, I'm seeing too much human. I want nothing. I need nothing out of you. Like, no, it was Devin. She was talking to Devin when she said that. But I'm like, somehow you don't really want nothing. You know, you told him you wanted nothing. You want nothing with a hint of something. And I don't know, whatever it was that she wanted, Lacey was able to channel it perfectly without even really being told. She just kind of got up there and did it.
Well, even though Tyra did tell them, because when they show up to the shoot, she's modeling for Mr. Tyra Banks.
Mr. Tyra.
And her doll name is Ty Biz Banks. So you know everyone's getting dumb nicknames this episode.
Was that
yes.
Lacey's...
No, that was Tyra's name.
Oh, okay.
Because when they walk in, remember, she's being photographed by
Mr.
Tyra.
She's redoing life size all over again.
Ugh, and I mean, that was the inspo for the week. And I mean, that just made my night, honestly.
She's like, remember when I was in this movie?
And she was like talking about
life size Barbie.
And I worked with a young Lindsay Lohan. I love how she like had to make the distinction, like not busted
back
ass.
Back in the day.
Not busted ass Lohan of late.
She added back in the day.
Yeah.
And didn't finish that by saying, when Lindsay could still.
And I think she meant still look gigs.
And she could still remember lines.
Yeah, we don't need to go there. But anyway, she definitely made it a point. And I was just as thrilled as Hadassah was, because she was like, I lived for life size when I was a child, and I have 300 dolls.
I collect dolls, and this challenge was made for me. And it really looked like it was, because when we saw it, she had the perfect doll expression and seemed to be hitting the perfect doll poses. When, at least during the shoot, it seemed that way. And so I was like, oh, I was thinking like, oh, she's going to be further up there because this actually looks pretty good. I'm surprised.
And she won. She was
on
the winning team.
That's true. She was on the winning team, although I don't think she deserved to be on the winning team. So I didn't process her as being
right,
the winner.
Right, I know,
at that
but you
point.
Still had to recognize points, point-wise.
Point-wise, we knew she was going to survive. I just thought she was going to be scored a little higher for the photo based on the shoot itself, because it actually... I saw a lot of moments that would have looked good in this, you know, theme of the photo shoot, but we got a really terrible one instead, again.
I mean, I feel like Mr. Tyra does this thing where he would benefit from this new hack, I can't think of a better word, that the iPhone photo is doing, which is like capturing the moment before and after.
Oh,
yeah. I guarantee you he's capturing the middle moment where there's nothing there. So Tyra's looking through like 100 nothing there photos. Do you think
they
look at the contact sheet together, like in bed, since they're
Ooh,
dating?
Ooh, they must.
Right? Can you just see them?
Is that a good like foreplay thing for Tyra though?
Oh, I don't know.
I was gonna
say yes, and then I thought about it.
Well,
like,
maybe the sense of power she feels in looking at people who are clearly inferior to her and as a model, maybe that makes her like all hot and steamy for him.
Maybe.
Oh my God, you did exactly what I wanted. You made all the pretty girls look uglier than me. You get a blowjob tonight.
Oh my
God,
let's pick the one where her face is out in focus. Good job, honey. You get $50 extra this week.
Yay.
Yay, Mr. Tyra. So everybody gets to model a doll inside of a doll box, and everybody gets a Tyra Banks vocab mashup. Is that a sentence? catchphrase?
I don't know what it is.
It's like her 30 never shit, but like four words too long.
So it was Niall was boom boom bon voyage. So he was supposed to be like, you know,
he was like
sexy guy on the beach on vacation.
I was gonna say, I was like, he was vacation Ken doll.
Yeah.
Boom boom bon voyage was like
bon voyage indeed.
Toot, he looked toot. Pretty oh my high. God. Well,
I'd buy that damn doll in a second.
I knew the second that he like came out in those like trunk shorts and like you saw the nautical like doll accessories that were associated with his look, I was like, oh my God, this is gonna be so good. I can't wait to see this.
Those are gonna
photo.
Fly off the shelf.
I mean, someone was greasing him up. I was like, yes, more.
See, how do you get that job?
I don't know.
There is a job of greasing
Niall
up that I need.
If there were any female PAs on set and that came up, like, they were probably fighting each other.
Gay male PAs, too.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, everybody.
Anybody who's attracted to men
anybody
that wants
likes
that
dudes
job.
Wants to touch Niall's abs.
Over and over.
So
there's not enough grease right here in the V of your boom. I just need to work it in there. There we go.
We don't need your translator. It's okay.
He doesn't need to be here. You don't need to know what we're saying. It's probably best if you don't know what we're saying right now. You don't want to know.
No. So he looked great. He was definitely life-size Ken. I was very into it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he was like, he looks better than Ken because he actually has like a beard and looks like.
And he has an actual penis.
That's true. He doesn't have like a strange
amount.
He has
genitals instead
of. He doesn't
have
a mound of plastic where his penis should be.
Ugh, he doesn't have an angry inch bump.
No, it's not even that. You're
no,
being nice.
I am being nice. That's why, I could be even nicer to Niall.
So we should move on.
Yes, we should. But clearly the real team power, as we said,
the real Ken and Barbie.
The real team power of this whole episode was Lacey and Niall again.
We continue to just be in the top two, just fucking straight dominate. Like, they should already be signed to six modeling
they
agencies. I don't understand.
They're probably, you would think there'd be a bunch out there clamoring for them. Well, I guess for Niall there is. I still see tons and tons of like.
He must have an agent because he got on a union show. He was on that Separated at Birth show.
That's true.
Which is on ABC Family, which is nothing to scoff about. So
certainly not.
I mean, it takes a lot of work.
It does.
So, anyway, I feel like. They should already be signed if they aren't. But that's...
neither here nor there. They're clearly the
what
queen
was Lacey's
and king
doll's
position.
Name was what I wanted to ask you. Because now the name escapes me.
Oh, was
silly with like, the word Tooch, right?
Was
because
was it Tooch? The Tyra Tooch doll?
Something like that.
I think it was the Tyra Tooch doll.
Because her tie-tie tip was to not be sleazy?
Yes, don't be sleazy when you're trying to be sexy. Because which is odd because she's a virgin. So how did she... learn to be sleazy. Well, you know, you haven't had sex yet. All you have are the images of sex. And the images of sex are probably pretty sleazy.
I was going to say.
So let's... I mean, that just stands to reason. Tyra, think about it. Think about it just a little bit. Tooch doll. I'm going to Google this again.
So what's Lacey's doll's name?
Tyra Taught Me Tooch Doll. It's the Tyra Taught Me Tooch Doll.
Oh, my goodness.
Is who she was. I mean, Mame had an even worse one, Work the Hallway Like a Runway Doll, which is supposed to be like she's a new model who's just made it.
Because I interpreted when Tyra said that, I interpreted that to be, that was like her new phrase or something. And I was like, I feel like I heard that in a RuPaul song before.
Put the face in your walk.
But I feel like that would be like a Rue, like walk the hallway, like the runway. I feel like that would fit into any.
It would. Maybe it's in an upcoming album for the next season.
Yeah, maybe
of Drag
I'm
Race.
Just kind of like premonitioning it right now.
I mean, Mikey was Savage Smize.
Could someone tell me what the fuck that means?
Savage.
Because poor
murderer.
Courtney gets fierce fashionista. And she's like, I don't know what those words mean. I was like, oh, shit.
She's like, I know what fashion is, though. And I'm
like. She's like, I get fashion and I feel good about that. I'm like, you're so sweet.
And they put her in that, like, ridiculous mask thing.
I thought it was kind of cool.
But, like. They're asking, like, have you ever seen Italian Vogue? She's like, no. Like, American Vogue? No.
And why would you start at Italian Vogue? Start at American Vogue. Why would you start with the more obscure title?
Because her look seemed very much more like Italian Vogue than American Vogue. So I think they were trying to be like, oh, well, this is what inspired this look that we've given you for this doll. Like, so if you can picture that, then you can picture what you're supposed to be. But they should have known that she doesn't read that. If she wasn't feeling it when she got like into Avon the costume. Avon Lake,
Ohio.
And she even said, she's like, I'm too busy taking care of my disabled brother to spend time reading fashion magazines. So I just don't do that.
Which it's is a perfectly... It's sweet that she thinks that you have to read those.
Well, yeah, it's true.
You just have to flip through the photos. But, I mean, still...
Ain't nobody got time for that when you got important shit to do.
No, exactly. I completely agree with you. But I just mean, like, it's sweet that... She knows so little about them that she thinks assumed that
that's what you'd be doing with them instead of just flipping through. I would stop on this page.
I would not stop on this page.
It's
a very useful critique, Nicki Minaj. Thank you.
She's useful everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
In every possible television show that she has anything to do with.
So we don't really need to tell you how uncomfortable Courtney's photo shoot was as a fierce fashionista, especially watching her hands. Oh. Like, I just wanted to tell, like, put your fingers together. Like, a doll doesn't have, like, I mean, unless, nope, dolls usually don't have separated fingers. That's creepy. That's weird. They usually, their fingers are all stuck together. It doesn't mean with robot.
The doll hands. Like,
but she didn't have, like, she out. Had, like, a loose karate chop going on.
It was not good. We could tell just from that photo shoot that, but there was a couple moments where she like clearly was channeling like fierce model, you know, bitch kind of look, you know. I'm like, okay, I can see it there. Question is, was it captured on camera and with a shitty photographer? Most likely that is not the case. So of course the bottom three from the mini challenge turned out to be the bottom three in the main challenge again, because Bayo, we didn't even get to Bayo's doll.
I was going to say, I was like, we can't. And then we also have to get to Devin's doll and Yusai's awesome burn this week. Like,
oh, yes.
I liked it. I was really bummed that it didn't come true. But it was still a good burn. And he's not long for this world.
Like, I hope we'll see you next week. I'm like, well, I don't, but.
Well, it was clearly sarcastic.
Hopeful. I would say hopeful.
It was, but. I mean, I feel like Yusai really, yeah, you're right. I feel like Yusai was really fucking had it. Like, this is the last time I let Tyra sneak one of these artsy motherfuckers in on me.
He's not even artsy. He just
Well, you
looks...
know, Tyra's, like, definition of artsy.
Oh, yeah. Which is what's been saving him.
Yeah. And it was funny that it was, like, the bottom three were the three of them because it was, like, all three were Tyra's pet projects.
Mm-hmm.
And it just came high time that they needed to be on the chopping block. Especially with Bayo. I mean, we can talk a little bit about, what is it, H2T golf?
H2T'd up. So he's supposed to look like he's playing golf.
I mean, is anybody surprised that Devin's not a golf man? Like, he doesn't look... He looked so weird in those clothes. He looked very
He did look very plastic, though.
It was just because his skin's shiny.
That's not a compliment, but...
His skin is
He
shiny.
Looked phony.
He is phony.
So that he was, he should have been tailor-made to play, you know, this empty inside phony, basically.
But he's too twitchy to hold, and, like, he can't hold a pose. It's all about kind of, like, stiff, calculated, like, he's not stiff, he's not calculated at all.
He's always got ants in his pants and in his brain.
Yeah, he's just, if it's not the eyebrow, it's the hands. And, like, a doll doesn't do birds of paradise fingers.
Feel my fears, bitch. Smell my fears, bitch.
Feel my boom, bitch.
Oh, my God, Ty. That moment was made it 5 stars by itself last
Why
week for me.
Why isn't that a gif yet?
Well, we should just make it.
I think
both
we should.
Of them. That moment, I still can't. I just can't. Oh, which brings
Smell
us.
Smell my Yes. I don't understand why he chose that time to try and imitate Joan Crawford.
Has she ever stopped imitating her?
Joan Brian Crawford lives.
Still alive. Can he come back?
He can.
Joan Brian Crawford can come back. Let's hope.
Or maybe, I don't know. Well, that's a lot of people.
Maybe we'll at least see him again. Who knows?
Hopefully. Maybe they'll honor those who couldn't make it to the comeback episode.
Yeah. You're going to be competing for those who we are not bringing back. The people who were so terrible, they were eliminated first.
I don't know. I'm trying to do the Hunger Games whistle.
Was it it sounded like Jeopardy, actually. I was thinking like the final Jeopardy tune. But
also way. Works. But I think the main takeaway is that I can't whistle. So let's move on.
Just put your lips together and blow. Lauren Bacall can do it. You can do it.
H2 teed up
was a massive epic fail.
I feel like there's like a H to T pun to be made in there, but my brain can't make it today.
H to teed up is the pun.
I know, but like a pun
H to toe up, more like.
There we go. Thank you. That's what I wanted. Okay.
Yes, there we go. We got there.
Because
that's really what it turned. That's what it turned out to. You got to work through it all. You got to sound it out bit by bit and then combine them into your glorious fun. I guess you just heard the creation of a pun out loud.
You just got to see Samir's thought process.
That's how it works.
Small glimpse into the small Samir's running around in his brain,
crazy,
shuffling around files.
The crazy library in my head.
No, give me the other book. Send the ladder over.
Oh, my God. Yes, you knew. There's a lot of shelves up there.
Anyway, we should talk about Bayo since they were the bottom three.
Oh, yeah, his. He was the ugly
pretty punk.
Ugly, pretty punk. And it was, there's a lot more ugly than there was pretty.
It was more like growling.
Yeah, he kept growling like a dog. And I'm like, how is this putting you into the ugly? And it was supposed to be like Brit-inspired, like British punk-inspired.
That was just Tyra.
I'm like, okay, do you think that's the sound that Sid Vicious made when he murdered Nancy Spungen? Is that why you're growling right now? Because I don't think this is working for your photo shoot. It just wasn't. It wasn't. None of it worked. It looked terrible in the shoot. It looked terrible.
And he did the, like, rocker horn thing.
First of all, punks don't do that.
No, it was cheesy. I mean, I feel like he didn't understand his brief.
When she told him, like, you know, British, you know, punk, he was like, yes, darling. And I'm like,
That's tea time.
That is more,
oi, 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 up with the punks and shit like that. That's what you need
to
be
doing.
It's
more Downton Abbey than, like, ugly, pretty punk you're given there, sir. So, I smell disaster on that one. And after all, he was the one who said, I'm not here to make friends. So, it's like, it was just all
And then he kept
together.
Talking about sacrifice. He did. He was talking about how, like, I gave up everything to be here. I drove through states. He did not specify.
Well,
which.
He said he was homeless at the beginning of this sea cycle. He was saying that he was homeless, and I'm like, I don't know. I mean, granted, your hair doesn't look washed, but the rest of you, well, I don't know. I have no idea. Maybe he doesn't. Maybe he really is living out of his car. Who knows for real? But I just wasn't buying it. I'm like, what do you mean you gave up everything?
Well, he talked a lot about that and having to face stuff. I don't really remember because it was just like, oh God, you're just going home. I just know. You just know.
And of course, you know, DMA? DMA. Mm-hmm. So the M and the D and the C that was not allowed into the group.
Poor girl.
Like, did pretty well. No, Mikey didn't end up in the bottom. It was really
he's still in the middle, and I thought it was really funny that Bayo
was
like
on the bottom.
Yeah, I thought it was hilarious that Bayo was like, I've been at the beginning of the episode was like, I've been surfing in the middle of the pack. I'm like, really, the middle? Are you sure? Because I feel like it's closer to the bottom than the mid.
I'm sensing
middle bottom.
Middle bottom. You're more catfish than. What's something that skims the surface of the water?
I don't know, but salmon's better. So.
Something on the top. Something
people something
want.
Better.
something that's
not bears
spongy
want to
and
eat.
Squishy, no matter how much you cook it. Sorry, I'm not a fan of catfish, and I'm not a fan of bacon.
Yeah. So it was kind of the right choice. But, I mean, we forgot about Justin.
Everybody forgets about Justin.
That's why he didn't wear pants to judging this week.
What was his doll?
Something about being a baller and booching? Booching baller?
Booching baller. He was the... What the fuck was it? See, this is how forgettable he is. You can never remember... Boochin' Ballin'.
Ah, that's close.
He was Boochin' Ballin'. Hadassah was the flossom free spirit.
Oh, right. We almost
forgot. I don't get the flossom part because what was her flaw? She's a
beauty queen.
What was the flaw that we're talking about? The hairdo you gave her? Or, no. No, but she was maybe like, you know, peace and love, like flower child or flower child / hippie, flower children and hippie.
She should have made her like a princess or something. Or what about, how about her 30 never? Like, literally anything but flossom fairy? What was it?
Flossom free spirit.
Yeah, no, those words do not describe her. She was just
trying to, like, revive, like, the words that she's... It's all from the Tyra Dictionary.
Of course. Where else would it be from, Smear?
She went through her own glossary for this show, and then that's how she came up with the names for everybody. I mean, Fierce is an old one. H2T.
H2T is
ugly,
recent.
Pretty, Booch.
Tooch.
Work with an E, although it's not really hers. Smize, boom, boom, boom. You know, like she's hitting all of her classics, you know, all in this one challenge. It only really worked for a couple people.
Yeah, I don't...
saw from the beginning who those people were going to be.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. I mean, definitely the true middle right now that are probably, like, the most at risk next week would be Mikey, Hadassah, and Justin, because they've just been kind of... Not terrible, not great.
It's not memorable. Justin was even wearing short shorts.
He wasn't wearing pants. He wasn't wearing pants. Let's just call it. He wasn't wearing pants.
Like his shirt, like it looked like he wasn't, looked like he was just wearing underwear. And we still didn't even notice. He just like floated by without like even raising my heartbeat.
I mean, it's pretty, I don't mean to sound mean, but Tyra was like, oh, you got pretty legs. I'm like, who's she talking about right now?
Well, it's another one.
And I looked up, I was like, who's the... Ah, Justin. That's Justin. I forgot.
J Smooth.
Whatever.
They've stopped
More like J Forgettable.
Yes.
That didn't work, but...
J Rough? No.
Yeah, no, it's not... I mean, Savage Smize, I also did not understand. And Mikey, I feel like, just depends 100% on his hair. And I get that that's, like, his
look. Well, he did look like some sort of forest savage.
I mean, what did you say? He looks like the Deliverance action figure?
Yeah, he looks like an action figure for Deliverance. There's like camping and like you know, like raft. Like there's just like outdoorsy things around him. It's almost like who was the Crocodile Hunter, but like skinny and heroin chic version of him.
Oh.
Steve Irwin. Isn't his daughter on Dancing with the Stars or something? Bindi.
I mean, that's her, but I don't know the story.
But it seemed like that was the inspiration for the look as well. It was either Deliverance or it was like Steve Irwin, the Crocodile Hunter. And neither of those were a good look for Mikey. And, I mean, he had those sallow eyes. Just, they're not selling me anything except, you know, you're going to hide my body in the crawl space. That's what I get out of him whenever I see him on this show. And I'm like, I just feel like I'm going to be murdered by you.
I would agree with that.
I'm like, oh, you have a large stock of lime in your closet. This doesn't scare me at all. That's what all those murderers used.
Well, just only be concerned when you see the polyurethane bin that you're going to get into. Because they can't, you know.
Now I'm genuinely terrified. I can actually see all of this in his apartment. I know it's so mean.
We're moving a little far away.
We don't really know him. He could. I'm not guessing that he's a great, great person, judging from...
He's from Florida. How great can he be?
Florida has the Gatorland.
It has Gatorland and Ginger Minj, and that's all that's worth saying. Hey, oh, and Harry Potter
World. Harry Potter World. That's something.
So let's just, like, put all those things, like, in the, what, like...
They're already 30 miles.
Yeah, we can just, like, break it off, take it with us, and then the rest of Florida can just float away.
Hogwarts is already on an island of adventure. It's already separated.
Very nice.
From the mainland.
They're going to open the Harry Potter World in Universal LA, so.
Finally.
Then we won't need Florida anymore, ever.
But nonetheless, we do go overboard with him sometimes just because he's so creepy looking.
And also, he just hasn't really... I understand that you guys are in a bubble and reality show, blah, blah, blah. He just, like, has flown off the handle and has been really, like, aggressive and really kind of... especially that first night where he kept trying to, like, get girls to, like, sleep in his bed. He just was very creepy.
He did it
creepy.
With Courtney, too. And then he's like, Courtney, we are not a
Courtney, you're gross. And I'm like, you just need me to, like, remind you to eat. Like, he just acted like a dick. And I don't forget that shit.
And now he acts like
But until I do, which will be, like, when this is all over or as soon as you go
but
home.
But he even acted now like he wasn't even attracted to her at all. And I was like, but clearly you thought she was a viable option earlier in the season. So...
I feel like he finally has gotten, like, a little bit of a wake-up call. What he will do with it, I don't know.
Well, I don't know. He did give that little speech to people he was mean to, and Hadassah was more inspired to be more personable because of that, too. She's like, oh, well, I have things I can change, and I have room to grow, too. So I should try to do that as well. And that was, they were trying to create that story arc for her on this show. We'll see if it somehow improves. I don't see that happening, though. I do not see her making it to top three. I think, like you said, like...
I don't know if I see her going past next week.
And Devin, like...
Devin is gone.
But they clearly bring back Bejo. Well, they bring, like, everyone.
Well, they bring back everybody. But, I mean, we should also cover a little bit of Mame being in the bottom four. Like, I mean, it was already a four.
She was not terribly memorable. She was... What was her doll?
Worked the hallway like the runway. And it was weird because she was, like, on the phone.
I didn't understand that doll concept at all. At all. And I don't think she did either. And it's like, she wasn't terrible because she just looks amazing. And she
it wasn't her. I think
face.
It was like the theme. And also the styling was very off.
It was all not like adding up for me. And it, I mean, she wasn't in the bottom, obviously. But she, there was a bottom three because two people were being eliminated. So you have to have one left over whose heart is made to skip a beat, you know, before they find out they get to stick around for a little longer. And so I guess technically she was one step away from being in the bottom this week. I don't know if that's going to continue. I feel we'll see how she does on Ghosties.
Yeah, I don't know if that's going to be a reoccurring theme. I really do strongly believe that her, Niall, and Lacey are the top three.
Yeah, it's that's the vibe that I've been getting. So it's like,
Matter of time for everybody else.
So that's why it's like, even though it's like double elimination, like even though I could see little to no real reason for it to be a double elimination right now.
Other than
I was
just
not
to create
terribly,
a little bit more tension, because I feel like it's really obvious who the top
three are. Because
they're
going to bring one back next week to even it out. But then what, someone's still going to go home, so they could have just left it the same anyways.
Yeah, it wouldn't have really mattered. But I think she's going to like shock the models with this twist. She likes to do shit like that.
How shocked could they be? It's probably all in the contract they signed. But that would mean that some of them actually read it before they signed it. Or had a lawyer explain it to them.
You know neither of those things happened.
Well, they do that on some shows. They have like someone come in and explain the contract to you so you know what you're signing before you sign, at least on game shows. They always have somebody who comes in and like goes through like the main points of it. Like, this is what you're signing off on. They always sort of skip over the part where you sign away your life. You know, they're like, oh, if you accidentally die, we are not responsible. That's pretty much a standard clause in just about everything. For a while, at least. Maybe that's changed. I feel like you'd have to sign something like that for Top Model, because they make them do some crazy shit.
I think it's still pretty standard.
Sorry, we're not compensating your family for your accidental death in the course of
your
competition.
I think it was... definitely a Fear Factor thing, but anyway, memory serves.
Yes, it was.
But regardless, Mame was, you know, bottom four, and that was weird to see her that low. But her photo was not that great, but I really don't feel like it was her fault. Even though I'm sure the judges would defend it to the death that it was her fault. But, I mean, Miss J did point out that Mame's knees were locked, and so that definitely made her look really strange. Mm-hmm. It didn't give her more of, like, a doll-like appearance, unfortunately.
No, this wasn't her week, but I don't think it'll sink her, though. I think she's going to survive beyond this, because she still has a pretty decent personality that she might be able to use to win over some people on a go-see. That's always the...
She's charming, she's educated, and she's also, like, from the pageant world, and she's used to... I feel like she'll probably be most in her element at go-sees.
I feel like Lacey's gonna do well. It's just
she's
like
just,
too
this
well.
Is, yeah. She's because just gonna.
She's got the personality that seems like bubbly and friendly, and the kind of like clearly everybody's liked working with her so far. She's impressed other casting directors. I have a feeling that this is going to go well for her. Also, Niall, they're probably going to try.
There's probably
going to
be an issue
some
there.
Drama about you know
whether it's concocted by the show or not. It, we'll
there will
see,
be something about the fact that he
is deaf. Is deaf. We'll have that reiterated.
But hey, anything can be done to help him. I'm sure they'll find it.
So Devin gets spared, and he gets to remain part of the losing lots of letters rapidly.
DM is still alive.
Alive and well in the Top Model house, unfortunately. So Courtney and Bayo go home. And Courtney seems pretty upset, but I think that it's probably for the best. She should have taken maybe a slight cue from the chick that walked off that's, like, a recovering anorexic and, like, also has, like, depression.
The girl from San Diego.
Yeah. Cardiff by the Sea.
Something like that. Yeah. She was torn down by people because she had a boob job.
Yeah. She was attacked by that Stefano douche. But anyway, who will not be making... He won't be coming back.
Oh,
I don't see that.
Even if he comes back into the house, we know he's not coming back into the competition.
Oh, yeah, no.
That.
I meant, like, he's definitely going to probably be a part of that, like, are you fighting for your job thing. But I don't think he'll stay. I hope he's just a blip and not too much of an asshole. But it seems like Bayo, who storms off and makes everything super awkward in
his
harem pants.
Yeah, and his turban.
Oh, my God.
His long hair poking out of his turban.
So do we call PC on that? Do we call, like, cultural appropriation there a little bit, or?
I don't know. What do you call that? It's like.
He looks like a fool, is what I think.
I was remembering that scene from Soap Dish where she's like, you gave me a turban. I look like Gloria fucking Swanson. And I'm like, is that the inspiration for his look? It looked very much like that. And I don't know what he was thinking. It certainly didn't help him there. But the fact that, like, everyone tried to move into him, he's like, I can't. I'm sorry. I can't. And just, like, shoved off and, like, didn't want to even interact with people. I'm like, does he already know he's coming back next week? Because he was like, well, when the comeback happens, like, you know I'm getting... Like, I was like, wait a minute.
Well, as soon as
what?
He said that, yeah, I was like, wait, so it's still on? Game on? Tight. Okay.
Well, one of our fans mentioned that on Twitter, who was that somebody said something about the comeback episode. They're like, well, the next episode, is it the guy or the girl who comes back?
We got tweeted at by a fan, or I did, and she is actually based in the UK, and I know that right now they're on the cycle behind this
one. Oh, okay.
So she was, it just is really funny that they're at the same exact points in their seasons right now.
At the same time. Maybe that's how they timed the airing of the previous season to sort of coincide with the events of this season.
I don't know. Maybe. I mean, it's definitely following a formula, because that's what you do. But as soon as Bayo's confessional said, I'm going to come back, you mark my words. Not only are you not going to actually probably come back, but you just told us that there's comebacks. So that made me feel good. I was pretty glad.
I'm just hoping that he's not the one who comes back, because, you know, they still love
him. Who do you think will? I mean, I don't know. I don't feel like he has it in him to pull something out. Because once again, he talked a big game about, like, I'm the actor out of everybody. And I get paired with with Devin and with Courtney. And they're so weak. And everything, they're weak. And I can't stand them. And Bayo came out, his, like, acting part in that PSA came out way more comical than Devin. It was very strange. He was just kind of, like, shouting and acting really weird and, like, playing with, like, the skeleton.
And his own hair.
I don't know why they gave him all that hair. It looks really weird. It wasn't until Miss J mentioned something about androgyny when his picture came up. And I was like, oh, is that what you guys were going for? That it completely escapes him. It does not translate.
They just wanted to have Mikey, a black man version of Mikey on the show, too.
Oh.
Maybe is what I thought. Because basically she was so entranced by Mikey's long hair, she didn't change it. She liked it so much, she gave it to another contestant as well. Like, that's
added
how much
the length
she loves
to,
it.
Yeah, added the length to Bayo's already long hair.
Already long, yeah. And stringy and gross. And
yeah, at least it has some, like, fullness to it now.
Yes.
But regardless.
I don't want more of Bayo, I want less.
Well, I don't think that he's going to actually end up making it back into the house. Out of any of the eliminated models so far, who do you think might have a chance at coming back next week?
It's hard to say because a lot of them weren't really that great. Like, that one girl was good before they cut her hair.
Ava.
Mm-hmm.
The cool Christian.
I guess she's got a shot, I guess. I'm, like, trying to think.
I mean, I feel like we're just so convinced at who's going to be.
Pardon. Sorry.
I feel like we're just so convinced already, like, who the top three is going to be that we're just kind of like, whatever, guys.
Yeah, we already know
where this is all going. So I guess the more fun thing to talk about is who do you think is going to go home next week then? I mean, besides everybody that's already eliminated. And also, is Tyra going to do the point countdown for all the eliminated models so they can watch their chances evaporate in front of their very eyes all over again?
Oh, I feel like they have to.
Right?
That seems like a mandatory part of it.
She needs them tears. This is the last time she can get this many people in the room.
Yeah, there haven't been a lot of crying recently, so it's like her stock must be running pretty low.
Depleting. I guess she's just hoping for Mr. Tyra to take such an awful shot of the girls that it makes them burst into tears.
It's like love potion number 9 to her.
Mm. That's why she looks through their film at night together. I think we found it.
That's what it is. And she has to, like, huff their tissues, you know, like Dennis Hopper in Blue Velvet. But baby wants to fuck.
But she's huffing.
Tie baby wants to fuck.
That is so disturbing. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. We should create a new meme of that.
No.
Put Tyra's face in place of Dennis Hopper's and say, Tie baby wants to fuck. It's getting late, y'all. We done lost our minds.
It's fine. This is the perfect time to think. I mean, yeah. Anybody in particular you have any parting thoughts on?
No.
Any elimination predictions? Like, I mean, I definitely feel it'll probably be Devin next week for sure.
Yeah, but that's like after they brought somebody back.
I feel like whoever they bring back might survive and they might get rid of Devin or not. I don't know.
That would be very cruel.
That'd be hilarious.
I know. Well, yeah, I should have. That means hilarious in my vocabulary. Cruel means hilarious.
Yeah, I don't know. That would be good. That might be 5 stars.
Because I don't think anybody would be like, oh my God, it's so wrong. Because on Drag Race, they always get very upset. They're like, oh my God, like someone's going to come in and someone who's already hasn't been eliminated is going to be eliminated by somebody who was eliminated last week or 2 weeks ago. Like, that's just wrong. Here they'd be like, oh my God, Devin's moving out. Let's have a party. Somebody won't steal my phone so I can communicate with people. I'm going to celebrate, said
Niall. Well, Niall did make a comment about how he wanted to outshine Devin in particular this week during the photo shoot.
All he has to do is wake up to outshine him. I mean, come on, Niall.
That's a good burn. I hope Usai uses that one. Usai, are you listening? You should use that one. And then credit us.
But, well, duh.
Yeah, we'll sue you. Sue you like Taylor Swift.
Yeah. Did she win?
I don't know.
Oh. We had to pick somebody who won their lawsuit.
I'm sure she wins a lot of stuff.
So, you know, not like Carmen Miranda or Vampira. They did not win their lawsuits.
Well, any parting thoughts on the girl who got dolled up?
All dolled up. They all got dolled up.
Yeah.
So
the model testants got dolled up.
Well, at least it referred to the challenge. I am just very excited for next week because Ghosties is always like a miraculous. Designers Tyra ponied up to just well enough.
I'm curious because they've had some interesting people in the past. Like, do you think it's going to be more like Whitney from The Hills? What's her last name? Thompson?
I don't remember.
Whatever. Blonde Whitney.
Yes.
Hills Whitney. Maybe they'll be. They had a. God, remember what's her name? I was homeschooled. Mama, I'm
Victoria?
Coming. Yes.
Oh my Lord.
Oh, remember when she met Whitney and she like totally nerded out on her and it was very uncomfortable and unprofessional?
As opposed to the rest of her behavior throughout that cycle.
I mean, this was the time to hone it in. If there were ever a time, that would have been it.
I missed your voice. It's been 6 whole hours since we spoke last.
Mama. I'm coming home.
I'm like, I feel like she is a method actress, and she was just carrying that role through. That was like the epic marathon method performance there. I bet outside of that, she's completely different. It's like a totally different person.
You mean she doesn't work out like that in real life?
No, I don't think she does. I'm just hoping she does.
I just love that she was basically Matt Damon as Axl Rose. Do you know where you are? You're in the jungle, baby. That was for exercising. Because it was like, that's her running back and forth.
We do miss a presence like her on this show.
Yeah, you got to keep someone on there to bring the crazy sometimes. But that's
Devin this season. Devin is
but
the
crazy
one. But
he's not half as funny as she was, except for the whole, like, losing my virginity thing. That was pretty hilarious.
Oh, yeah. We're like, oh, it's my virginity in this business. I'm like, oh, yeah, because that's so difficult. That takes a lot of hard work to get to that level in modeling. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, no. I see him as definitely going home very soon. Like you said. But, like I said, we picture everyone except our top. We know. I feel like we call the top three. That is going to be a thing. Maybe that'll be the shock that they try to work into this season, this cycle, is that one of those three is going to end up not making it through some. They're bad one time, and
right,
that'll be
enough. Some sort of banal challenge. But hopefully they make it overseas first.
I hope so. Where do you think they're going to go this year?
I don't know, because it's coming up, right?
Very soon. It's usually... Actually, the ghosties are usually in the other country, aren't they?
I think we had the same discussion last cycle, but they haven't done that in a while. They haven't done that since all of the models kept getting...
They did them in Seoul.
Did they?
Yeah, they did ghosties in Seoul.
But they did them twice then.
Remember, because Will had a problem because he was too tall for all the clothes. So they did that in that.
But I feel like they did it twice last cycle then, because I feel like they had ghosties in LA as well for LA Fashion Week.
That was one of their challenges, like a mini challenge or something. It wasn't even the main challenge.
I got it.
It was like, she does do that sometimes. She's done that a couple times where it's like, hey, we're going to actually try to see if you can get some runway work. Let's do this. And some of them do. And it's but it's not like their go-see challenge, like their specific go-see challenge. So like, even since the
but
first...
But I feel like that's a good prep, though, for go-sees.
It will be revealed. Maybe the part in the pool is before we find out who's going on the ghost. Because did we see any footage of the ghosties? We didn't.
Mm-mm.
In the preview. We just heard the words. I don't know. We'll have to go through it with a fine-tooth comb, just like the final picture with the removal of Bayo.
The removal of Bayo and Courtney, who were on the right side and evaporated quite nicely.
Mm-hmm. So you have a nice view of Lacey, mm-hmm. I think.
I think so. I feel like her, Niall, and... Well, Ma May's kind of off to the side, so I feel like if anybody fails that, like, last curveball test, it might be her.
That's true. Because sometimes somebody off to the side does make it. And usually the person that's right in the center doesn't, and Niall is right in the center. You know, luckily the photo cuts off below his package. It's a nice thing to see every week at the end of the episode. So that, to me, is hinting that he may not be the winner because they're not always there. I feel like Lacey is very primely located.
Mm-hmm.
And she seems to be getting the winner edit. But
has she... But if we know anything about Top Model, yeah. We know that some sort of body check edit is coming up for her because she can't possibly be on this high arc without a very sharp...
Basically,
turn.
We'll know who wins when we get to the final three because the first picked, the winner of the challenge before the final three is never the winner of the whole, almost never the winner of the whole show. It's usually the person who's in the bottom two and doesn't go home and goes on.
Well, obviously.
It's usually that person who's like in the bottom for that first part of that last episode. That person usually ends up being the person who wins. And that's their like, oh, this is my moment where I had to check myself, where I almost went home. Right before the end, and now I'm not going to let anything get in my way, and I'm going to rock this, and I'm going to win, and then they do, and that's usually what happens. But I'm trying to think who that's going to be this year. Maybe that'll be the moment for Lacey.
We'll just have to watch and find out.
Yes, it'll be a surprise who comes back just to go home in another episode.
Right, because we all know that you're not going to last.
Oh, well, I'm excited for it.
I like to watch them squirm. It's fun.
It makes me healthy again.
Well, if you're watching along with the show, you should definitely listen along with us for our podcast every single week. Top Model moves to Friday next week, so we will be moving to the end of the week as well. Or, I mean, kind of probably closer to the release schedule that's already happening now, because we usually have these up by Friday or Saturday, so now we'll definitely be Saturday and or Sunday.
Or, yeah. Or you can begin your Mondays.
Mondays listening to Top Model and laughing along with us, and make sure that you read our reviews on the Gambit magazine site. If you're listening to this podcast, you're either probably listening to it on the YouTube at Gambit Digital, or you are a genius and you've subscribed and download this every week through the podcast app on iTunes. If you haven't noticed already, there are never any commercials. It's just us rambling at you for however long we can ramble at you for that. Any break or pause. So why don't you return the favor and like drop us a line on Twitter or like leave us a nice little review or something. Because the same for the love of the game, y'all. This is for the love of our own egos and for the love of Ty Ty Baby, who would probably strike us down for not including her in this outro. Our reviews are always live on Gambit Mag. We do other things besides Top Model, though not as frequently as we usually do. But you should still check out the other reviews because they're hilarious and awesome if you like reviews. If you want to holla at me on Twitter, I am at MargSheWrote.
I'm at SamirMiraculous. That's my name, Samir, and the word miraculous. Combined into one, it's still difficult for me to even wrap my head around, but I chose it and I'm stuck with it now. So, at SamirMiraculous. Or at Smiracles on Instagram. That'll be like, you know, it sounds similar. That's what I should have done on Twitter, actually, because I don't think there was a Smiracles.
Should we just start like a Samir hashtag so it's easy to find you?
I have no idea how this will work. People find me
somehow.
We're
still trying to figure out Vine. We can't figure out how to aggregate hashtags.
We know how to work Vine. But nonetheless, you can find me on Twitter at Samiraculous. Find me on Instagram at Smiracles. You can, of course, always find us on the Gambit Magazine website. Or, of course, you can listen to us on Gambit Digital on YouTube, which I have a feeling many of you are doing. Because we're available for all of you all over the world for free.
Yes. And until next week, we bid you a bye.
That was really good.
What?